Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. In this video, as you probably can already tell from the title, I'm going to be talking about some of my favorite recent skincare finds slash purchases. These items are truly one of the best skincare products I've tried in years, and the best thing is they're all very, very affordable. So without further ado, let's jump right into this video. I'm gonna start with an oldie but a goodie, and it's not a recent purchase, it's a recent repurchase for me, but it's truly a great item. This is a CeraVe moisturizing cream. I used to have one with the pump. I don't recommend getting the pump because for me, the pump basically ended up falling through, so just a regular screw-on cap works best, I think. But this is an awesome product because it is a great lightweight moisturizer that actually moisturizes your skin incredibly well. This is not the strongest possible moisturizer. I do have something stronger coming up, but this is a very good, like, all-around kind of moisturizer that I personally like to use right after I get out of the shower, and I apply this and I let it kind of soak up into the skin. This does feel kind of lotiony on the skin. It doesn't completely dry, but it's not a greasy feeling whatsoever. It doesn't have any fragrance. It says it's gentle on the skin. It also says it's non-comedogenic, but I will say from personal experience, I do think it caused me acne when I applied it on my face, which is why I said it's a body moisturizer. I actually tend to get acne on my chest and my back as well. So if I feel like my skin is a little iffy during the day, I would actually not apply this lotion or any lotion really on that area, just because I don't want to have anything extra, just to be on the safe side. Okay, on that note, I'm gonna reach down and I'm going to grab another CeraVe moisturizing product. This is the Daily Moisturizing Lotion. Now, this is from the same line as this, and both say they're non-comedogenic. And as far as I can tell from the ingredients, there's only one that's in here that's not in here. However, this is an awesome product for the face. You can apply this all over the body, but I think it's especially great for the face and even around the eyes. Where I cannot apply this around my eyes because it causes me that, like, just unpleasantness when it gets into my eyes, which it normally does because it just slides down in there. This one I have no issues with. I like to apply this around my eyes. I like to apply this on the face, and even around, like, areas on my body that's acne prone that I would want something lighter like this than this. This has much more of like a, almost like a jelly feel. I wouldn't necessarily describe it as completely jelly, but it has a lot more lightweightness to it because, I mean, it is lightweight. So I just wanted to mention both of these. This is like my body moisturizer that's a little bit heavier. This is a great face moisturizer that's lighter, that will still do a great job of moisturizing your face, but is not going to cause issues around the eyes and for acne. That all being said, this is just my personal experience. I'm sharing it with you, so I cannot guarantee that you're gonna have exactly the same experience, but I would just say, for me, that's how it worked out. Both great products, though. I was always of a mindset that this is basically a watered-down version of this, but that's not the case. They do feel different. I feel like they perform differently. I feel like they have different uses, so this is much more intense, and I would skip it. Unless you have a drier area on the body. So for me, my body is very dry and my face is quite oily and dry at the same time, but it's acne prone, so I cannot really go like full on moisturizing it unless I want to have a huge acne breakout, which I don't. So yeah, I save it for my legs and my arms basically, which are dry, and this I save for my face and for my like chest area if I feel like I need to go a little bit lighter on something like a heavy moisturizer around there, because I do tend to break out like right here. So this is a recent purchase. I've been absolutely loving it though. I'm so happy I gave it a try and I didn't just think that this was a watered down version of that. I did watch a dermatologist actually recommend this specifically for acne prone skin as a moisturizer. And I was like, interesting, it was this, not this, even though they're both non-comedogenic. You would think that if they didn't cause any acne, you would want the stronger moisturizer, but she specifically recommended that and it was a great recommendation. So I'm passing that on to you guys. recommendation. Okay, I said it normally now. All right, next, I think this is the last CeraVe product, I promise. But this is the another one actually that same dermatologist recommended. This is hydrating facial cleanser. The reason I love this so much is that it's a no-nonsense basic moisturizer cleanser for your face. This is something I use if my skin is irritated, if I just need a very, very basic cleanser. I wash my face twice a day. Now that's a personal choice. I think everyone's a little bit different, so do whatever works best for you, but I like to wash my face twice a day. And I try to use this either once a day or twice a day, depending on how dry my skin is. The other time I would use a benzoyl peroxide for my acne prone skin, but otherwise if I didn't have acne issues, I think I would just use this. And I love this so much. It's a really great, again, no nonsense, basic facial cleanser. I think it's really well priced. I'm not mentioning prices for any of them, but this one, depending on the size you get, it's like $10 to $20, but $20 is like a large size. I think this is like $13 to $15 for a tub, and the tub does last you for some time. This was like $10 or something like that. And again, these are really large sizes. If you're getting this as a facial moisturizer, this is gonna last you for forever. So really great value for your money. This is around, I don't know, $10, $13. I will link everything down below, so the prices will be there, but everything is super affordable. That's the gist of it all. Anyway, I love this a lot. Also, CeraVe is known for their ceramides, which I don't wanna make a fool of myself and say something wrong, but ceramides are really good for the skin and they help to build up skin's barrier to prevent loss of moisture. So yeah, I know that this is a brand that's highly recommended by dermatologists. And when it comes to my skincare personally, I'm gonna do a little side note here. I don't wanna get too off track, but just a side note. For me, skincare is all about the efficacy and how well the item's gonna perform. I don't care about the brand name. I don't care about marketing. I wanna have it have good ingredients and I wanna make sure it works. So I tend to stick with like the dermatologist approved skincare because I feel like they would know better. Let me explain that. I don't necessarily look at a label and says dermatologist approved because I don't really always know what that means and like what that really is all about. But I do tend to listen to dermatologists and the general products that they recommend, and CeraVe is always at the top of the list for pretty much like any dermatologist I've ever listened to or spoken with. So anyway, I absolutely love, love, love this moisturizer. I keep calling it moisturizer. It's not a moisturizer. It is a hydrating facial cleanser. That's probably why I'm keep calling it moisturizer. I will be honest, I don't know how hydrating it is per se, but I do think it's one of those like very non-irritating but get the job done kind of a cleanser, which is perfect because if you have acne-prone skin, I never had issues with this cleanser. And if you don't have acne-prone skin, this is still a good option because it's very kind of, I want to say from personal experience, it's a very gentle cleanser, but again, it does cleanse your face because I have oily skin, so I want to make sure my face does actually get cleansed and washed. And especially if you have, you know, if you wear makeup like I am right now, then you definitely want to take your makeup off and then cleanse your face. I actually have my absolute all-time favorite makeup remover to be mentioned, but it's one of the bonus items because it's a little bit more expensive, but I promise you it's so worth it. So I'm going to mention that probably at the end as like a bonus item that's not technically as part of like the rest of the items. Okay, I'm going down for a second. I'm just gonna get some more stuff here. Okay, next item I wanna talk about is this very new recent purchase. This is the Eucerin Roughness Relief Spot Treatment, triple action, ta-da. I honestly love the tube, the packaging, so I was like, ooh, it looks very like serious. Do you know what I mean? Like it looks very serious. So I bought it because I saw I think Dr. Dre talked about it on her YouTube channel, and she has recommended really good products in the past that I've tried that I liked, so I figured I would give this one a try as well. Eucerin actually has a bunch of products in this line right here, and I thought kind of the same thing as I did with CeraVe, that this is just a repackaged version of like a lotion that they sell that's basically gonna be the same thing, just a little bit more expensive. And I think I'm wrong because this really does a great job of intensely moisturizing your skin. Now this is a small tube, so it's not something that you're going to be probably wanting to use all over your body because you're going to run out of this so quickly if you do that. But that's okay because I actually think a little goes a long way. B, it's not very expensive. And C, you will only need to use this on smaller areas. So for me, I tend to use it on the backs of my arms because I have, let's get fancy for a second, keratosis pilaris slash chicken skin is what it's called on the streets, if you will, which I can show it to you. It's not the most pleasant thing, but honestly, I used to care about it more when I was younger. I don't really care about it as much anymore. However, I feel like number one, it's getting better. And I think it's probably because of this. I have tried so many things for that. And I think this is one of the things that is really helping a lot. My keratosis pilaris is actually spreading a little bit. I used to only have it in the backs of my arms and now I have it on my thighs. But honestly, with my moisturizing upkeep and moisturizing slash exfoliating, it's been getting better. So I tried this and I really love it. I feel like it not only moisturizes, it also exfoliates your skin a little bit as well, because it does have urea, which is the second ingredient in here, which is why you don't want to use it too much. I would try to use this around like really rough areas slash calluses. I have something for calluses. It's not the most glamorous thing to talk about it, but I found an awesome product, actually also recommended by Dr. Dre. Anyway, so I would use this somewhere where your skin is a little bit rougher and can handle it more so than in other places. Like, I wouldn't use it where your skin is really thin. I also wouldn't use it on your face. I'm not saying it's not gonna work per se, but I just don't know if urea is the best thing to apply on your face. But I have found that for my keratosis pilaris and for any rougher, dry areas like elbows, knees, feet, this is a really great product and a little goes a long way. So I think one of the better items there. So anyway, the next item is Norwegian Formula Hand Cream Fragrance Free by Neutrogena. I love that it says Norwegian cream. I don't really know what that means. I probably should have done a little bit more research before making this video, but I do really love that it's marketed as that, because there's just something so like enticing to me about that. Anyway, so this is a really awesome hand cream. I've tried a couple of different types of hand creams, and to be honest with you, a lot of the times I would just use this before going to bed as my hand cream, because that's really the only time I ever use a hand cream. I've also tried using this right here, but this leaves a little bit more of a film on your hands. For being so extremely moisturizing, this actually doesn't feel greasy or anything like that. It does go on kind of like a gel, actually. It's not what I expected it to be like at all. I expected it to be very greasy and just like uncomfortable. I actually had a product from Eucerin that I loved. It came in a tub and it was, it felt like a kind of like a greasy cream. It worked great, but I just didn't love the way it felt on me. This is totally different. This feels like a gel when it goes on, and after that it leaves like a kind of like a slightly tacky, kind of a velvety residue, but it's noticeable. So it's something I would probably wear before going to bed. It's not like uncomfortable. It's not a bad residue to have on your skin, but it's definitely there. It doesn't like completely soak up into your skin. So I tried using this as a hand cream because I was like, oh, maybe I'll compare these two. Like, maybe you don't need a hand cream, which you don't need a hand cream, but I wanted one, so I got one. And I'm glad because it was a good product. But I tried using this as a hand cream, which I think would work perfectly fine, but it did leave a little bit more of like a residue on my hands than this. So let me just apply this and I'll tell you exactly how it feels. I feel like, by the way, this does do a great job of, by the way, this is what it looks like. Again, it goes kind of like a jelly substance. By the way, I do feel like the hand cream does make a difference. My hands were much softer since using this. I've been slacking the past couple of days and it shows, because my hands are getting drier again, so I really should start using this. But you don't have to wear it just before going to bed. That's just what I do because I'm lazy and I don't apply during the day. But for a hand cream, this is definitely one of the more intense ones. That being said, because it's more intense, it also, I think, leaves a little bit more of a residue on your hands. So it's something you want to keep in mind, because I personally really don't like hand creams for that exact reason. Most of them, if it's a good hand cream and if it's worth applying, will leave some sort of a residue. So you can try to apply it like this and not touch your palms, or you can just apply it at night, which is what I do, so that you don't have to deal with that. Because the really good ones I find tend to be like heavier and tend to have a little bit of a residue, and the thin ones don't really make a big difference because my hands, especially around my cuticles, get really dry, and so I need some serious moisturizing. So anyway, this does have kind of like a matter, again, like kind of like that matter velvety finish. It's not like greasy feeling, but there is a residue, so something to keep in mind. However, I think it's a really good option. This was very, very inexpensive. I want to say it was a couple dollars, like $3-4. Not the biggest tube, but again, you don't need that much product to just apply on your hands, so I think it's a really good option. But again, keep in mind, this is not going to be extremely like non-existent after you apply it, so just probably best to be saved for nighttime if you can bear it. Okay, coffee break. Next product is not incredibly glamorous, but I feel like it works so, so well that I want to mention it because I think it's going to change your life. If that's not dramatic, I don't know what is. The product I'm talking about is Carousel Intensive Foot Repair. It's a small tube, but you only need a little bit, and you only want to apply it on the calluses and the very, very rough, tough areas of your feet. This works incredibly well. Again, this was one of the things that was recommended by Dr. Dre. I kind of went on like a binge watch of her videos because I feel like she finds really good products and recommends them, and I try them and I like them. So some of the things I'm mentioning them are her personal loves, and I've tried them myself and I do really enjoy them as well. This is one of them. I would never have tried it actually if she didn't recommend it, because I would think it was, I don't know, I probably wouldn't have done my research and I probably would have got something that was a little bit more marketing-y. I actually have used a urea-based foot lotion before, which was great, but it was one of those lotions that wouldn't really dry properly and it would feel really greasy, and I would have to wear socks to bed, and it didn't feel good, so I didn't really apply it all that much and it didn't really work therefore that well. This is actually quite different. It comes out like an ointment looking thing, and then you apply it on your feet and it does dry like more matte than greasy, which is great. I typically wear socks with this for a little while. I tend to apply it like after shower, so I wear socks before going to bed, and when I go to bed I take the socks off because by that time this would like dry down and soak up and all that stuff. But I've worn it a couple times for a couple days. Not worn it, and I applied it for a couple days, and my feet were noticeably different, like a lot smoother, a lot softer. It's just a really, really great product to make your feet look really like perfect, you know, like soft and smooth and all that stuff. And I do tend to get calluses. I don't want to be kind of like gross here, but I do tend to get calluses sometimes, and so I have to stay on top of that, and this is one of those really, really great products. Okay, next item is also kind of weird, but I want to mention it because I just recently bought new razor blades for it. And that is my Harry's razor. It's not sponsored. I feel like that was kind of like a infomercial sounding bit there, but it's not. It's not sponsored. I've actually had two Harry's razors before. One I kept at my boyfriend's, one I kept at my house. But now that we live together, I have two. I actually like the feel of the cheaper rubber handle better, but I like the look of the metal one, so I tend to use this more than I use this. But honestly, if you want to save some money, just go for the rubber one and you'll be happy with it. I think what I love about Harry's razors are the handle. The handle is really comfortable, but that's not the biggest thing for me. The biggest thing I think are the razor blades, which was a recent repurchase, so I figured I'd mention it in this video because this was literally one of those like revolutionary moments for me when it came to razors. I've had a bunch of different razors over the years, and I think this is my favorite one out of all of them. So the blades are very affordable, which is pretty uncommon for razor blades. I feel like they're always so, so expensive. These are very, very affordable. Let me just see if I can go ahead and open them. Comes like this, and then you open it up and then you have four in there, and I used up one already. So that's how the razors come, and the actual razor blade head is very, very great at both shaving the hairs but also being gentle about it, because I feel like some of them tend to either not shave well or they tend to like kind of nick me in weird places, you know, like around the knees. And although you have to be careful with any razor, including this one, but I feel like this is just the perfect combination of like, it completely hugs your skin when it glides. Like it just has a really flexible head here. It also has five blades in there. So it really shaves, it shaves all your hairs, and it's really comfortable as well. So I just love it. I've never really had any kind of skin issues with this one, and I have had some with other ones. I would shave my body like every day or every other day, and my boyfriend wouldn't really say anything about it because like, why would he? I mean, it's not really anything different. But when I changed the blade finally, he was like, wow, your legs are so smooth. And I'm like, I can't say I shaved because I shave all the time, but I did change a blade. So you want to make sure you keep up on those blades. And thankfully these are not super expensive, so I don't feel too bad for doing that. Okay, Harry's razors for the win. Love them. Been using them for a couple of years now, actually, so true fan. Another weird shower thing. Sorry, I was just going down there to fetch the rest of the products. I was just actually talking to Larry, my boyfriend, about this new product slash new trick that I've discovered, which is about teeth whitening. So I've discovered an amazing product for teeth whitening and a technique that I feel like together work incredibly. I'm gonna show you my teeth really quickly. So my teeth are not the best because I wasn't always the best in brushing them when I was younger, and I loved my sweets, so I have a couple cavities in the front. But so my teeth are right here. Sorry for making a rude expression. So my teeth tend to get stained from coffee and tea that I drink daily, and especially I have staining in the front in between my teeth. And I've tried different ways of getting rid of those like stains and darker yellower spots, and I can't. Like I couldn't for the longest time figure anything out. I've tried whitening strips, I've tried other things, and they would whiten my teeth, but still they wouldn't get down into like those like in between teeth areas. Well, then I've tried this specific product. This is Colgate Optic White Advanced. I've actually been using it for a while, and the first couple times I've used it, I was like, oh my goodness, my teeth are actually so much whiter. When I got it at first, I did not believe it would do anything, honestly. I was like, okay, I'll try it, whatever. But it honestly, it worked. I promise you, this really worked. Not sponsored, I'm not working with them, but I just feel like it really did make a difference. Like, you have to be, like, you have to have expectations. This is a toothpaste. It's not gonna take you from, like, you know, brown teeth to like white teeth in one use, but I felt like it made a visible difference with no amount of effort other than brushing my teeth, which I would do normally. And this is not a very expensive product either. I think it is a little bit more expensive than like a regular toothpaste, but it's really not like that much more expensive. I think maybe I spent like a dollar or two more a month, but my teeth are so much whiter that I feel like it's totally worth it. However, the one thing I want to say is the technique of this matters, especially for your front teeth. So I brought my toothbrush here. I really got prepared for this. So this is my toothbrush, which by the way is also a really, really great toothbrush. This is Philips Sonicare. I've used a toothbrush like this for years. I've actually had to replace it, I think, once because it just over the years it gets worn out. So but anyway, I really do enjoy this toothbrush. I do think it makes a difference in the health of your teeth and also in the whiteness of your teeth as well, because it just cleans them so much better. Anyway, so the technique, I'm not gonna actually brush my teeth, but I'm just gonna demonstrate it really quickly, because again, over the past couple days, literally days, I felt the biggest difference. So I would use this toothpaste, and normally this toothbrush, you go 30 seconds on either quarter, like 30, 30, 30, 30 up top. But what I do is I actually take some of that time, and instead of going like this on my teeth, right? So like holding it kind of down the way I'd normally hold it, I actually hold it like this, and I literally go up and down and scrub my teeth a little, not hard or anything, because you don't want to scratch them or anything, but I would kind of put some work into it and use this toothpaste and go like this. Up and down with the actual like bristle ends touching the teeth. Made all the difference. I swear my teeth are whiter now in the couple of days that I've done it than they were before, and I've literally noticed it today. That's why I mentioned it. I wasn't going to in this video, that wasn't a planned thing, but I was sitting in front of my window and I was like looking at my teeth and like they're actually like so much whiter. And I'm not saying they're the whitest teeth you can have at all. In fact, this tooth right here is actually a filling, so it's a little darker than the rest. A little secret there. But I feel like because I literally don't do anything to whiten my teeth whatsoever, it's just that toothpaste and it's inexpensive, it's zero effort other than just like brushing your teeth. And I feel like it's, you know, it's a no-brainer to do that. I also drink a ton of coffee and tea, which stain your teeth. And if I can whiten them, I feel like you can too. So I would give that a try if you're looking to kind of like no-nonsense whiten your teeth. The next item I want to talk about is adapalene gel. This is essentially a topical vitamin A. Now, what this is used for is acne. But more specifically, what it does to your skin is it makes your skin turn over, the cells turn over faster. So essentially, it makes your skin exfoliate better and more frequently. And then that unclogs your pores and prevents acne. So if you have acne, number one, or if you just have kind of congestion skin that looks a little bit more duller, that doesn't seem to want to exfoliate itself like mine does, this is a great item to try. This is an over-the-counter product, so you can go down to like Walmart or any kind of a local store and get it yourself. It's also very inexpensive, which is great. And it does for me, I've experienced prescription ones and over-the-counter, and the over-the-counter one, this one specifically, is a lot less irritating than the ones I've experienced that were prescription ones. I'm assuming this is less strong though, so there's that, but my skin is much less irritated from using this. Side note, this will cause a little bit of dryness, a little bit of peeling if you use it too often, too much, or if your skin is very sensitive. Something to keep in mind, but basically what it's doing is it's clearing your skin out. The first thing that you might notice when you start using it, besides that kind of like dryness, irritation, if you use too much of it, which honestly I haven't really experienced that much with it, in conjunction with using this right here, which is a gentle cleanser, and this moisturizer, my skin hasn't really been too irritated because of it. But the first thing you'll notice is what's called a period of, what's it called? Purging. It's called purging. And that is like not fun at all. Your skin will basically get worse before it gets better, kind of a deal. My skin got so much worse, I almost chickened out. But the same dermatologist that recommended this right here also said that your skin will take months to clear out, which I know sounds like not what you want to hear, but there's kind of no way to get around it. If you have acne that's already formed in the deeper layers, it's gonna come to the surface anyway. And what this product does is basically makes everything come to the surface faster because it's turning your cells over faster. So instead of seeing a few pimples now and a few pimples later, you kind of see everything much closer together. So it seems like your skin is just like going crazy. And I mean, it probably is kind of, but it's going crazy to go normal and get better. And I will tell you that after using this for, I think, a month or so, my skin is noticeably better. It is so much better. Now, I'm also cognizant of touching my face, of what I eat. I know if I eat a lot of chocolate, for example, or a lot of sweets, I tend to break out around my lips. but my skin is so much better. And so this specifically, I think, is designed for acne, but I think Retin-A is what a lot of people use for anti-aging, and I've heard really, really good things about it. I've never use it myself because honestly I'm on a budget, so I chose this because I am looking for acne first before anti-aging. But if you want to, you know, dip your toes in the water and see roughly how the whole thing feels for you, then I would definitely recommend trying this out. Again, I don't know how good it is for anti-aging, but if you have acne, if you have congestion, if you want to have something that exfoliates your skin a little bit chemically like this, you want to be careful. You don't want to apply this around your eyes. You don't want to apply too much. You want to take it slow. But other than that, I feel like this is an awesome product. It's inexpensive, it's over the counter, and I think it will probably improve your skin dramatically. Just watch out for that purging period because it is brutal. Okay, the next item is also a little bit more specific of an item, but I have been enjoying it, and it is a Scar Away 100% silicone scar gel. It was also recommended by Dr. Dre, and I'm so glad I tried it because I think it's also making an actual visible difference in my scars. I have a couple of scars. One of them is a new one on my foot, And normally I really don't care about scars that much, but this one is dark, it's big, and it's like just really noticeable and not very pretty at all. So I don't know if I can show it to you, probably not, because it's like literally at the bottom of my foot. But I really wanted to try something that would hopefully diminish either the size or the color of it, just the overall appearance. And I did some research and she said that this would be the best one. What I like about Dr. Dre specifically is she is an actual dermatologist, so she can read the research. And with something like this, I don't care what the marketing says, I just want to know that it actually scientifically is proven that it works. And she said silicone gel is something that does work for scars. So I have been using this roll-on silicone gel. I actually haven't done it today, so I'm just gonna quickly put it on my scar, and it goes on like a jelly paste, and it does dry down more or less. I think it makes a difference. I've been using this for about a couple weeks, I think 2 weeks, and I notice a difference. My scar is currently fading on one side, not the other, so I'm a little bummed out about that, but it's making progress, and that's all I'm asking for. I also want to say that just because you have a scar doesn't mean that you're not pretty. Scars aren't the worst thing in the world. I actually have scars like on my knees, and in fact, I actually saw a post recently that says if you don't have a scar on your knee, did you even have a childhood? Which made me laugh because I was like, I think, you know, maybe I'm not the only one that has scarred knees from childhood. But anyway, so scars aren't really necessarily a bad thing to have. Please don't think that I'm like shaming anyone for having a scar, but I don't blame you if you want to get rid of it, because I certainly want to get rid of this one that I have specifically like in a bad area. It's like really dark for some reason. And honestly, I don't know how I got it to be a scar, because all it was, I know exactly when that happened, by the way. I was carrying like a presentation board, like a light foam presentation board, and it fell down on my leg, kind of like this. It scraped my leg and I bled a lot, but it really wasn't like painful. It was a foam poster board, and now I have a scar from it. Like, who gets a scar from dropping a foam, you know, foam poster board on their leg? Honestly, I do, I guess. Okay. All right, on that note, great product. The last two products I have to share with you are a little bit more bougie, but only one of them is a little bit more expensive. Anyway, the first one is this one right here. This is Jack Black Intense Therapy Lip Balm. I got the flavor Natural Mint, but it comes in more flavors than that. This is one of those super popular items that I've just never tried, but I was like, enough's enough, I need a good lip balm. Give it to me. So I gave it a try and I'm so happy I did, because it is literally such a good lip balm. Such a good lip balm. This is under $8, so it's not terribly expensive and well worth the price. This is designed actually for guys, and I believe one of the marketing things is that it stays on matte. I've actually never noticed that. I do actually like, by the way, that when lip balms end up being kind of glossy, because I'm like, oh, I'm wearing lip gloss. This one I think is designed to stay a little bit more matte, a little bit more like incognito, so guys don't feel like they're wearing like really glossy anything on their lips. It has a really, really nice minty flavor, which is nice because like it freshens up your breath a little bit. It feels kind of tingly on the lips, but the best part is that it is a really like thick balm consistency, and it works incredible. My lips have been really soft. One thing that a lot of other lip balms would do to my lips is make them peel. It's kind of weird, but my lips would like peel. They would be moisturized, they would feel nice, but they would also peel. This one doesn't do that. It basically makes my lips feel very moisturized, very soft, and just gorgeous. And the whole reason why I was looking for new lip balms, to be honest with you in the first place, is that my boyfriend has really nice moisturized lips all the time, and my lips would peel and be cracked and dry and chapped and all that stuff. And so I'd be like, gosh, I feel like I'm, you know, I feel like I need to step up my lip balm game. So I reached for this. I tried it out for the past couple of weeks and I've been absolutely loving it. So I would highly recommend giving this a try. Even though it's not the cheapest, it's also not really that expensive and it works great. Okay, oh my goodness, I think we're almost done. I've been talking for a hot minute, as the kids say it. But the last item I want to mention is actually a little bit more expensive than the rest, but it is such a good item. I've been loving it. This is my second tub of it. And the product I'm talking about is the Clinique Take the Day Off Cleansing Balm. This is the balm.com. I love this. I wear a lot of makeup if I wear makeup. I either wear no makeup at all or like go out and, you know, put on my makeup. So I need something that is really strong that can take everything off my face, because like I said, I do have acne prone skin. I really think that with makeup, no matter what kind of skin you have, you want to make sure you take everything off so that your skin can breathe, so that you're not clogging anything, all that stuff. So this takes everything off. It literally melts your makeup right off. It's a balm consistency. It's smaller package, but you do end up having a lot of uses out of it, which is great. It also is great at removing eye makeup, and it doesn't get in the eyes and sting them. I wouldn't necessarily try to get it in the eyes because it doesn't really feel like incredibly comfortable, but it's not like a stingy feel either. I've actually been using for a long time, because my mom buys it, the GHC olive oil based makeup remover, which is great. It does do a great job of removing makeup, but if that one gets in your eyes, it really feels very uncomfortable. This one is much, 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 much less so. And that's important, because if you're gonna be taking your eye makeup, you're gonna obviously have this product around your eyes, and so you want something that's gonna be gentler on your eyes, and this one is. So I've been loving it. It is so, so, so good. I did bite the bullet. I was gonna try to find something cheaper, but the thing is, there's really nothing cheaper out there that I feel like just as good. I also love that it's a balm, because a lot of the times when I would try to use something more liquidy, I would try to squirt it on my hand and it would go all over the place and I would spill some of it. And the balm, you don't have that problem because it's a lot thicker. And then once you apply it on your face, which I'm not gonna do now because I wanna keep my makeup on for a little while longer, but I will be using it tonight. Anyway, when it goes on your face, the warmth of your skin melts it, and then it turns into not oily necessarily substance, but kind of like a milky, you know, liquidy, balmy kind of a finish. And yeah, it does a great job. An awesome, awesome job of removing your makeup. So if you're looking for a good, like, intense makeup remover, highly recommend this. I don't know if you're into like makeup wipes or micellar water, which I do actually have micellar water makeup removers and really like them, but I don't tend to use them all that often for like a regular take the day off kind of a deal. Do you get that? Because it's take the day off. I use something like this because I want something heavy duty. 5 stars, great product. Okay, on that note, you guys, that is all of the products that I wanted to share with you today. I feel like this was kind of a random bunch of products, but I swear these are incredible products. And again, like I said in the beginning of the video, I just want to reiterate that this is my personal opinion. I'm totally honest with you guys and truly love all these products, but I cannot guarantee for sure that you're gonna love them. I think there's a really, really good chance you will, but I just want to say really quickly, I'm not a doctor, I'm not a dermatologist, I'm just a girl who has skin that could use these products, and I've been loving them, so I just wanted to kind of share that with you guys. Okay, on that note, I hope you have a wonderful day. If you have tried any of these products, let me know that down in the comments below, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye.